Welcome back, everyone, to Showbiz India, and I'm at the fantastic new restaurant, Tapestry. You know, here's Suvir, who is an award-winning chef. So, Suvir, you obviously have spearheaded many Michelin-star rated restaurants. What was your inspiration to create this menu for Tapestry?
You know, menus are a personal journey, but more importantly, they represent where you are. The Greenwich Village where we are, Greenwich Village is very eclectic, very eccentric. It's always been on the cutting edge of what New York City is. It's also part of a gypsy parade where artists have always traveled all over New York, but this is a grounding place where some of the most cutting edge things come out. When thinking of Tapestry, the name, we thought of intersection of the globe, where in one weave you have every identity of the planet being represented. So the menu had to be something that takes cherry picks from around the world in a sophisticated way yet gives comfort. So we have comfort foods of the world represented in a small menu so that you can be from Italy, France, India, Morocco, Mexico, and you'll find a dish that's comfort food from those areas. Pozole, the soup we have in our menu, is a marriage of pozole from Mexico and harira from Morocco. So both cultures will find something familiar in that one bowl. And the dish represents both of them quite honestly and authentically. So I have something for everybody, but the menu had to be global because the village at the end is a very cosmopolitan, very 21st century representation of the world is. The cocktails here also sing and dance with the taste buds.
Absolutely, it's fantastic, so delicious.
We are hoping that from cocktails to the serviettes, which are hand-woven for us in Italy with Egyptian cotton, nobody else will have them in the country. Everything we do is unique, it's special, and it's a memorable experience for people to remember forever.
Absolutely, and you know, the minute you enter, it is just beyond your imagination. It's so open, and that's a rarity in New York.
It is, but it's also something New Yorkers love. You know, the decor isn't yelling India. India comes out in these little details that we have on the wall in all of the Madras checks that we put out in wood rather than in color. So if you think about it, you won't think Madras checks, but when you look at it, you say, yeah, this is a check pattern. So India is coming out in unexpected ways. I was making a pasta today with fried cauliflower and pappardelle pasta. But India came out in the love that I had for my friend Rick Tuturo, who died. And you know, when he would make it for me, I loved the pasta, but India came out in the chilies that I'm adding. And when people eat that pasta, they're like, oh my God, I've never eaten a pasta like this. So Rick lives, the memory lives, and India comes in with a little heat that India brings to the pasta. So that's the way Indians, you know, we are greedy for flavor, and we are hoping every dish takes people to a new realm, a new place, where India shines in unexpected ways.
Let's talk about the menu. Your menu is extremely eclectic, different, with a little fusion, but not fusion, you don't like to call it that.
You know, fusion to me is confusion, but the menu, what we are doing, we are celebrating the globe. So if there's a rabbit terrine on the menu, it's as French as a terrine can be. But again, India comes in the sensibility with which we present it. The Japanese little red colored board that we presented it is handmade in Japan. The grazings, I call them the rabbit grazings, are carrots, fennel, pansies, and Johnny jump ups, the flowers that are of spring that a rabbit would eat in the garden. Then when we eat the rabbit has pernil, fennel, and also pistachios. So a French person wouldn't do it per se, they would have just kept it all rabbit. But the Indian in me loves flavor, loves color. So the pistachios add color, the fennel and the pernil give flavor. See, again, these are ingredients a French chef would have, but may not have used. So we bring them together for the Indian hunger for flavor.
There's a lot of Indians who are vegetarian. What would you suggest they come in and try for the first time?
The Brussels sprouts chaat. We had Indians come in, non-Indians come in yesterday at the opening.
Let's repeat that, Brussels sprouts chaat. Actually, that popped out to me when I was reading your menu.
Indians and non-Indians alike are shocked by it. My business partner, Ronnie Majumdar, who is Bengali, you know, he's been hearing about this Brussels sprouts chaat for almost a year. When he ate it yesterday, he said it was unbelievable. He couldn't believe it. The sprouts are treated in three ways. One is deep fried, the other is oven roasted. And the third is each petal of the sprout is removed and then deep fried crispy. So you have three textures that come into the plate. And then there's a raisin chutney, a imli ka chutney, there's a hari chutney, there's a ginger chutney, and then the chaat masala, kala namak, bulat jeera. They all come together to give you these layers of flavor and textures that make a chaat, but also make a chaat more global than Indian.
Okay, so after the chaat, what should they order?
We have a cabbage and avocado slaw, which is this dirty salad, as I call it. It's it's soggy, it's flavorful, it's dirty, in that it takes you to places where you just want to keep eating. You want to be off camera and just have your face in a bowl and licking it clean. And then it has a crunch of peanuts. So that's another dish. We have the Rick's pasta that I was talking about, the pappardelle with the cauliflower. We have a mango grapefruit and pineapple salad that's almost, it's almost like a doctor has come to your place. It's so astringent and clean. But then when you eat it, these pops of flavor, hot, sour, salty, sweet, all come alive. And you're like, oh my God, I could eat this all day long. So India has given us so many vegetarian dishes that are comforting. Mm-hmm. Each menu, each season will have 4 or 5 vegetarian dishes that a vegetarian can eat with pride and go home quite sated and happy.
Nice, so let's end the meal with dessert.
The desserts are never forgotten at Tapestry. We have a pastry chef who's working hard morning and night to give unexpected dishes, but with a oomph of flavor. We have right now 2 that are very special. One is a sticky toffee pudding. The sticky toffee pudding is as English and as old as India, as our time with the English, as our colonists were. My mother made it with dates and a butterscotch sauce. We make it here the same way, but it's presented in a basket of caramelized sugar that is almost spun to look like a weave. And it's crunchy and crispy. The butterscotch pudding and the sticky toffee pudding sit on top of that. And then a tweel made out of caramel sits on top of that as a garnish. So when you bite into it, crunch and layers of unexpected earthy caramel whiskey flavors come alive. The other one is Il Flottant. My grandmother and her mother would make this French dessert called Il Flottant, floating islands, made with egg whites and egg yolks. The custard is egg yolk, the meringue is egg white. So Nani made it plain vanilla like the French would make it. But in our kitchens, we don't do anything just boring and plain. We are making it with a lemon custard, a lemon and saffron custard. And then we make a tuil, which is a crisp of almonds and cardamom and a little lal mirchi. So your mouth is just a little hot and then the custard will cool it down.
So Suvir, I'm very, very hungry listening to you. So I've walked in and I would like to have the chef select a meal for me. I'm non-vegetarian. I can't leave those people out. I eat everything. What would you serve me?
We have a fried chicken that people who've eaten fried chicken across the world say is a game changer. It's all that fried chicken is crispy, crunchy, deep fried, but ours has a fountain of juicy flavor. It has almost 21 spices from India that are brining the chicken. And when you bite into it, this fountain of flavor comes alive in your mouth. We serve it with aloo bharta, which is a Bengali mashed potatoes with mustard oil, lal mirchi, dhania, piaz and hari mirchi. So that is without oil but full of flavor, and we serve it with a slaw, a peanut slaw, that is crispness, crunchiness and yumminess all in one. So this together as a bowl, if you eat meat, you'll never eat another bowl of meat. We have pork chops that are juicy, unctuous, served with caramelized apples. So wow. These are apples that are made with hing and lal mirchi and a little bit of vinegar, sirka. And then they're fried till they're almost melting into a brown mush. And they are just beyond anything you've eaten. And then the pork chop is juicy and perfectly cooked with a roasted cauliflower side. Incredible.
Well, now I'm famished.
And the rabbit, of course, the rabbit terrine.
Yeah.
If you eat the rabbit terrine, you'll want to be French and always eat it every day.
Wonderfully said. So we wish you loads of success.
Thank
Cheers
you.
To you. Cheers. And Tapestry.